Besides the emboss command, the August 2020 update has also added the ability to create parameters on the fly. Before this update, to create parameters, you had to first go into the change parameters command and add new parameters here before using them anywhere else. With this update, you can create parameters directly in the sketch environment. We have an undefined rectangle here. Let's say that we want to create a parameter called length and set it to a value of 20 mm. Begin the dimension tool. Click on the entity. With the dimension field active, start typing in the parameter name, followed by an equal sign, and followed by the desired value. After you press enter, the parameter gets recorded even though there is no indication at all by looking at the dimension. To check this, go to Modify, Change Parameters, Expand Model Parameters, locate the sketch and the dimension, and you should see the length parameter. From this point on, if you add a new dimension and type in length and enter, the dimension value would automatically change to match the original length value of 20 mm. The FX at the front indicates that this dimension is linked to the parameter. If we change the first dimension, which was used to create the length parameter, the second dimension changes accordingly. If we go inside the change parameters command again, you can see that the value has been updated here too. Here's a tip to improve the use of parameters. Favorite the length dimension by clicking on the star. This dimension gets added to the list of favorite dimensions. With the parameter set as favorite, when you add a new dimension and start typing in length, you can see that as soon as I type in the letter L, a drop-down list with the length parameter appears. As soon as you see this, enter once to select the parameter, and enter again to confirm. This ability to create parameters on the fly is not restricted to the sketch environment. You can practically do this any place where you are asked to enter a dimension. For example, while creating an extrude, I can enter the word thickness here in the dimension field, followed by an equal sign and a value. Let's go into the change parameter command to check. And let's favorite this parameter. If I perform another extrude and start typing in thickness, you can see the thickness parameter appearing for selection.